This video is sponsored by Usercentrics.
Did you know that there are people charging more than $10,000 for a single website? And to prove it, here we are on Webflow's partner program. And if we filter by higher price ranges, you can see there are plenty of agencies that are starting at $10,000 or even more for a website. And it's not just a few. If we scroll down, there are dozens of agencies that are charging that price. So it's very common for people to charge $10,000 for a single website. In this video, not only are we going to cover what goes into a website that's worth $10,000 to a client, we're going to show you how to build a website very similar to the ones that you see here on this page using AI that you could potentially sell to a client for more than $10,000. And there's one tip at the end that you're not going to want to miss that really makes the website stand out. We're gonna jump into the actual building of the website with AI shortly, but first, let's take a look at this premium partner on Webflow. One thing that's really nice about Webflow is that their partners display actual examples of websites that they've built. We know that these websites are worth $10,000 because that is what the starting price of this agency is. And you can do this for any of the partners on Webflow to get inspired by what is worth $10,000. So let's click into a couple of these websites to see what makes them stand out. So first of all, they've got a nav bar with multiple pages. So usually it's going to be more than one page for over $10,000. That would just be a landing page if it's one page. They have kind of some nice scrolling interactions. So that's something to keep in mind. Also some interactions here with the testimonials. And it looks like they also have some nice interactions here. So interactions is something to keep in mind. And if we scroll down a little bit more, we also see some nice animations. And this is also some pretty cool kind of animation as I move my mouse on here. So again, something to add is also some sort of an animation as well. So interactions, animations, and multi-page is what we have so far. Of course, it's a very clean, nice design. And here's the multi-page, as I mentioned. Here's another example from the same agency. So we've got some nice animations, again, multi-page. We've also got some nice animations here and interactions. If we keep scrolling down, again, some movement that helps make the website feel more premium. Just some nice background, kind of splash color here. And of course, the design overall is really nice. And here, again, we have kind of some nice tabs to go through different features. More animations, like we talked about before. And again, animation and interactions. Okay. So there's a few things that I'm going to keep in mind as we build our website with AI. Multi-page, obviously really nice design, some animations and interactions on the page as well. So I'm in Bolt, which is the AI tool that we are going to use to build this website. The prompt that I wrote is I'd like to build a super premium and extremely well-designed website for a self-driving car company. The product being sold can be added on to any car to make it self-driving. So I've come up with a kind of fake product here that we can use for our website example. The website should be premium and worth at least $10,000 to a potential client. It should be optimized for SEO. So I want to use Next.js. This is a coding language that, just for some technical reasons, is going to be better for SEO. So I would want to use this for a $10,000 website. If you were building an app, then it's less important which language that it is in the back end if it doesn't matter about SEO. Remember, the website should be amazingly designed and high quality. Even Steve Jobs would be very impressed. So let's go ahead and send this prompt. Now, you might be asking, why didn't you include anything about animations and interactions and multi-page like I talked about initially? So when I'm doing my initial prompt with AI tools, I like to make it a little bit more defined and then later on add on more features. If you add too much into the first prompt, then the AI can start to get confused and the end result won't be as good. So before it even starts coding, Bolt comes up with a plan with core features and design elements. And without me even asking, it already knows that it should be including subtle micro interactions and animations that enhance the user experience without being distracting. So just like when we went over before we started what goes into a $10,000 website, Bolt knows that already and puts that into its plan. And in just a second, I'm going to reveal the first draft of the website that Bolt creates for us. Bolt has created the first version of our website. If we scroll down, we can see it has some nice animations as we scroll in. Overall, a pretty good design. and it has some pricing plans as well and some animations as we kind of open and close these FAQ sections, and a form as well on the bottom. Before we jump into more design upgrades, I want to say a quick thank you to today's sponsor, Usercentrics. Usercentrics offers a product called Usercentrics Cookiebot, which is a cookie consent solution for compliant use of cookies and online tracking. I'm going to show you just how easy it is to add to your website. It's as simple as adding a line of code in your header, which I asked Bolt to do, or with sites like WordPress, you can simply use the Usercentrics plugin, and now your website automatically has a cookie consent solution. It automatically tracks, classifies, and blocks cookies, and automatically updates when regulations change. It integrates with the most popular CMS and site builders such as WordPress, WooCommerce, Shopify, Wix, and tools like Google Tag Manager, and even AI tools like Bolt, as you can see here. If you want to sell a $10,000 website, adding a cookie consent solution is a great add-on to offer to your client. If you want to add a Usercentrics cookie bot to your website, click the link in the description to check it out for yourself. Let's get back and keep improving the design of this website. So we're going to ask Bolt to take this design to the next level. I'm asking it to add high quality animations and interactions throughout the website and clean up the design everywhere. If it's a 6 out of 10 now, make it a 10 out of 10 design. And ignore that and then go ahead and send this prompt to just overall improve. So I'm going to pause the video while Bolt makes these changes. Let's check out some of the improvements that it made. So first, when I hover over these buttons, we've got some nice interactions. If I hover on any of these features, you can see the icon here is floating a little bit, which is also a nice premium interaction. We've got some really nice header transparency with like the blur behind it, which is very nice. So overall, we're making some really good progress here. Let's do one more thing before I give you a playbook of how to take this from the draft website to an actual website that you could deploy for an actual client and take everything to even the next level. So I'm going to ask Bolt to please make the website design more unique and really stand out. Think deeply about how to do this. And what I'm going to do is then switch to discuss mode and send that into Bolt. So what this is going to do is allow Bolt to come up with a plan of exactly what to do, and then I can click implement these changes. So this is a nice hack with Bolt to improve the output of your prompts. So a couple things it added. One, it added just some more animation here, and also it added this cursor that's kind of following me around, which is kind of cool. The actual movement here is maybe a little bit busy, but it is interesting that Bolt kind of made that change. If I scroll down, we just have kind of better interactions here. So the color is kind of highlighting as we go into different ones, which is really nice. And if we scroll down, overall, it's iterating and kind of continuing to make improvements. This is just, it seems to be like some package error that keeps happening, but I'm just going to ignore that for now. I'm going to try one more thing and see what Bolt does. So this is a prompt hack that you can use to try to get the AI to think a little bit differently. So I'm going to say these are just subtle refinements. I want it to be big and unique changes. Come up with some ideas. So of these changes, I'm going to say, let's go with the glassmorphism design and also add interactive micro interactions. And let's ask for those two things. I'm going to remove discuss and send it off. So if we scroll down, we can see it added a little bit more of this glass morphism effect to the cards, which it said here. It added some underlines, like these little micro interactions. So overall, it is adding more of these premium features. Of course, when you're building a website, you want to make sure that it's not going overboard. But this is really interesting to just see what Bolt is able to do as we ask it to keep iterating. A few things that I would recommend doing before finishing this project is, first, I would build some custom icons for each of these features, which you can do with ChatGPT Image Gen quite easily. So that's what I would recommend, and have them all be a consistent style, like a modern 3D blue car, for example, I think would be really cool. You could even screenshot this, and I'll show you how to do this. So why don't I screenshot this car? So I sent a prompt to ChatGPT to take this icon, turn it into a 3D version of the icon with a transparent background, and it should be the same blue color, but in 3D. So this is pretty amazing. This is an awesome icon that you could use that is automatically going to make your site look a lot more premium than this basic 2D icon. So what I would do is I would go through each of these icons. So I would find, here it is. I would go through each of the icons. I would create 3D versions of them, and then I would replace them on the site. That's automatically going to make it look more premium. I would do the same thing with the logo here. That's automatically going to make it look more premium. Of course, if you're building a website for a real client, you're going to have access to really high quality images. So I would, of course, change the image in the background to make it fit with your client and look really high quality. So just by making those simple changes, I think that I would do the same thing with these quote icons. I would make those 3D as well. So just by making those changes, we're going to take this from a really good website to an incredible website. I hope that you're getting inspired by watching this video. Be sure again to click the link in the description to check out our sponsor, Usercentrics. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free content like this. And if you have any questions at all, please leave a comment below. Thanks for watching the video, and we'll see you in the next one.